Congratulations. So proud of you. Do you guys realize he won his first professional fight last night? He was so good, you should have seen it.
I'll get you iced teas, okay?
I guess my lucky penny worked, right?
I'm never gonna fight without it.
Ruby! Ruby! Where were you last night? Jagger won! He won! He was so good!
Terrific, terrific. Next time I'll put up the close sign and I'll be ringside.
How do you do that like that? You were so good. I mean, just bam, 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 and that guy just went down like that. You made it look so easy.
Well, I just met this guy that I didn't like, right? So I just picture my fist hitting his face. And then it was easy.
Welcome home, sweetheart. Would you like me to put this upstairs?
No, that's okay. I'll deal with that later, okay?
Sure.
Well, it must feel good to be back in your own home.
The truth? I don't really care where I am, just as long as this nightmare gets over, you know?
Look, it's gonna be over very soon, huh?
Tiffany, we're gonna find out who killed Jessica.
Yeah, well, what if you don't? I mean, what? Sean's gonna go to jail, what, maybe forever for some murder he did not commit? Is that it?
Hello. I'm like the welcome wagon here.
Well, it's not officially mine yet.
Didn't the landlady give you the keys?
Yeah, but, you know, she has to do that credit check thing, you know, on me.
Ah. Well, what about the cleaning crew? Weren't they supposed to come in here and clean?
They did already, but, you know, I never feel like it's clean until I do it myself, you know?
Ooh, that's kind of a very obsessive, compulsive disorder you got going there. Well, let's take a little break here, all right?
Well, I haven't really started yet.
Mm-hmm.
What kind of plan is that?
You don't know what this is?
No.
It's a money plant, or it's an honesty plant. Well, the guy in the plant store didn't give me the scientific name for what it actually is, like a ficus, something, I don't know.
So?
No, but it's yours.
Very nice, thank you. Why do they call it a money plant?
You see, these little pods, they fall off, you know, and they dry up and they look like silver dollars, and then you pick them up, you go to Atlantic City, you put them in a slot machine, and some big money.
Sure.
Uh-huh. Really.
Thank you.
I also got you a church key and a flashlight.
Oh, boy. What would I do without you?
I don't know.
I need to ask them something about their daughter, Catherine.
You can ask me. I'm their daughter.
You?
Yes, I'm Catherine Crawford.
What are you smiling at?
General Hospital.
Take care of those ice keys.
Okay. Must be kind of weird for you to be completely out of Jagger's life.
No, Brenda, it's not weird. It's a relief.
Come on, Karen. It must bother you a little bit that Jagger tells me everything now.
What do you mean, everything?
Just what I said. I mean, we practically live together, you know. I know what he likes and what he doesn't like, where he goes, who he sees, and vice versa. I gotta go. I'll talk to you later. You told her?
What?
Brenda!
What are you talking about?
She just said that you told her everything.
Okay, come clean, Lucy. What are you up to?
I'm just happy, that's all.
Happy about what?
Life.
Life in general?
You got it.
Uh-huh. You disappeared for a couple of days. I hope you didn't do what you told me you were going to do.
Oh, I'll give you 3 guesses.
You went to Serenity?
Mm-hmm. I also went to Rochester, too.
And?
And I met the nicest people.
Oh, Lucy, get to the point. You're dying to tell me, so just spit it out.
Well, just guess who I met.
Lucy!
Okay. Okay. I met Catherine Crawford. The real Catherine Crawford.
What?
Guess who is not the real Catherine Crawford?
Oh, this is ridiculous. What'd you do, hire someone to play Catherine Crawford? I can't believe all the energy you're putting into this nonsense.
Fine, Julia, just bury your head in the sand.
Why are you doing this? You fly all the way up to Manhattan, you go to Rochester just to dig up something damaging on Catherine Crawford?
No, you're not listening. Her name is not Catherine Crawford.
Oh, stop it. You know who's going to get burned doing this, don't you?
You. No. No, I am not this time, because I knew from the first minute she waltzed into town that, whatever her name is, something was wrong with her.
Catherine is a very nice person. I like her. Scott likes her. Everybody likes her.
I don't.
Give it up.
Oh, you know, this really amazes me. I come in here and I tell you, I went to Rochester. I found someone that grew up with Dominique, and her real name is Catherine Crawford. And you're telling me to give it up? I don't think so. Where's Scott? You know, I checked his office and the machine was on.
He's over at Catherine's new apartment.
Oh. Well, he's going to a lot of trouble for nothing.
Well, why don't you just scurry on over there and spill the beans on Catherine?
Maybe you can drive a really big wedge between you and Scott. I have a little prediction. Do you want to hear it?
Not especially.
Well, too bad. I predict by the end of this day that our little Miss Wedge will be packing her bags and leaving Port Charles as fast as $250,000 can carry her.
Let me guess. Books.
Yeah, that's why I had to rent a car. Excuse me.
Are there more down there?
Well, yeah, and I came with some more ship from New York, but they're not here yet.
where do you want me to put these?
Anywhere. I sort of need a bookshelf for those, don't I? And gosh, I sort of need an everything, don't I?
Well, look at this. We take this. Look, on, up, a little end table.
Oh, that's great. Sort of a college dorm kind of thing. I wonder where I could get a beanbag chair at this hour. And, oh, you know what I could really use is some cinder blocks and boards to make a shelf. You know, maybe, like, right along this wall. What do you think?
What are you going to do with your album crates, man?
Oh, this is really depressing.
Well, listen, wait a second. I'll think of something.
I'll figure it out.
I'm an idea, man. Always have, always will be. I got something going.
No, I know that look. You just stop right there, okay? I can take care of this. I'll manage. I have been here before, okay? I mean, how much furniture do I really need?
Shush! Shush! I'm thinking. I see what I see. What you talking about?
Brenda said you told her everything.
Listen, if you mean about the Paradise Lounge, I didn't. I didn't think it was important enough. Besides, Karen, what do you care if people know about your new career? I thought you were happy. Was this another part of your specialty acts, or what?
Think what you want, Jagger.
Well, I am planning to. Excuse me.
Ah,
Now what?
Murphy?
Yes?
I've been thinking about this a lot, and, working here and trying to keep up with school and my job at the hospital and everything, it's just getting to be too much, and I'm really sorry, but I have to quit.
What happened between you and Jagger?
Oh, nothing. It has nothing to do with Jagger.
That isn't what your face told me just now.
Ruby, really. I've just got too much going on, that's it.
Look, I've worked out a schedule for Jagger so he can work with Marco and Fi. I'll work out a schedule for you.
Ruby, a schedule isn't going to do it. I just don't have enough hours in the day.
You're leaving now?
Well, you're okay, right? Jagger's here.
That isn't what I meant. I thought perhaps you might like a little time to think about it.
No, I'm positive. Thank you so much.
You just keep coming by so I see your sweet face, and I want to know how you're doing, because I worry about you. Besides, the customers love you, too.
Thanks.
Okay.
I don't know. You tell me.
Karen just quit.
She what?
I made this myself.
Have you talked to the DA's office yet?
No, not yet.
Well, why not? I mean, Sean, you can't just sit around and wait until you're sentenced, honey.
Honey, I'm not. I'm not, okay? Well, why haven't you at least talked to Abby?
She seems reasonable enough.
Well, she is very reasonable, yes.
Thank you.
Part of the problem.
What do you mean?
Oh, come on, Felicia. I set myself up, remember? I know how strong the case is against me.
Then why don't you just tell her what happened, Sean? Tell her that you thought you were protecting me.
Honey, it's not as simple as all that. We have Robin as an eyewitness. She saw me with the murder weapon in my hand. Abby has my fingerprints over everything, and no one else's fingerprints. And besides, she already has my confession.
Okay, Sean. Does she know you? I mean, have you worked with Abby before?
Yes, I know her. 100%.
Fine, then she can't possibly believe any more than we did that you killed Jessica.
I wouldn't count on that if I were you. I'll tell you something. You work in the DA's office long enough, and sooner or later you're going to see it all.
You still have to tell her the truth.
No, not yet, no.
Why, Sean?
Now, because whoever did kill Jessica thinks they got away with it scot-free. I change my plea now, then lower after them.
And we lose our advantage.
Exactly. So we lay low for a while, conduct our own investigation.
That's terrific. You know, what if you don't find the person who murdered Jessica before you're due in court for sentencing?
Don't worry.
You want one of these? Oh,
no,
sorry.
I'll get it. Yeah. Oh.
Surprise.
Hey.
Lucy, hi, come in.
Hi. Listen, Julia told me that I could find the two of you here, and since you don't have a phone, I couldn't call first.
Right.
Hey, Lucy, flowers for me?
No, they are not for you.
Oh?
They're for you. Just a welcome to your new apartment gift. I thought they were kind of pretty.
Well, they're gorgeous. Thank you.
Oh, you're welcome.
Boy, I really like this place. It's very nice. Yeah, I like it, too, or at least I will once I get something to sit on.
Well, now, I told you not to worry about that.
Would you forget about whatever you are brewing up, okay?
Lucy, we were about to have something to eat. Are you hungry?
No, I ate already. Thank you.
Well, how about something to drink? I have water or water.
No, thank you very much. I don't need anything.
So where you been, Lucy?
Oh, didn't you get my message?
No, I didn't.
Rochester. I had a call from one of our deception buyers. I've worked with him before, and he told me he was having a little problem getting our displays. So I thought, hey, why don't I take them up there and help set him up?
I bet it was beautiful up there.
It was just absolutely lovely. It was very nice in the department store. Oh, you should see it. Well, I suppose you probably have seen it.
Oh,
Harrington's?
Yeah. Yeah, I love that. It was built, what, like in the early 20s or something, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm. You know, they used to build everything with such detail. They just don't do that these days.
No. Gosh, all that beautiful wood paneling and those
painted murals above the elevators. And you know what I really like to check out in old buildings is the bathroom. You know, all that special tile, the intricate uses they had.
Hmm. Well, trust me, there aren't too many bathrooms that I miss these days. You know why, you know who.
Mm.
Listen, I just had a wonderful idea. Since you won't be able to cook here this evening, why don't I take you and Scott out to dinner?
Wait a second. Did I just hear that from way over there? The acoustics in this place are great. Did you say that you were taking us out to dinner?
Really? Yes, I did.
Hmm.
You know, the buyer I was talking about earlier had some very interesting ideas. At least, I thought they were interesting.
Well, I think that I should really keep at it here. Maybe we could set something up for tomorrow, maybe.
Oh, you know, Catherine, you're going to have to eat eventually.
Well, I thought we would just order a pizza.
Oh, pizza. No, no. Listen, I insist. I want to do this.
Yeah, I say we ought to do it because it's not very often that, you know, Fred Mertz here buys anything.
Okay. Great.
Then it's settled. Okay. Why not the Port Charles Grill? And make it kind of early, don't you think? Maybe in an hour or so?
Okay, in an hour.
Sure. Thanks for the flowers.
Ah, you're welcome. Well, I'll see you two later.
In an hour.
You okay?
Who knows?
Must be very rough on you, Karen, quitting.
It's not rougher than working with her.
I guess you're not going to tell me what happened between the two of you.
I can't, Ruby. I made a promise.
Then I'm not going to ask.
Ruby, listen. Karen's a totally different person now.
No, she's not, honey. She's the same.
The Karen I used to know would have never said the things she told me. She told me to get lost. I don't understand her. I'm not going anywhere in my life.
You believed her.
That's what she said. She also wants me to stay out of her life. But I don't know if I can do that.
Then don't.
Yeah, do you have any suggestions? She won't talk to me. And she won't tell me why she's doing the stuff that she's doing.
Honey, you obviously know more about what's going on with Karen than you're telling me, because you promised her not to. Just back to that. But I do know one thing. The two of you care for each other very much.
How do you know that?
Because I'm an old lady and I've been in the block a long time.
So what do you say?
I say help her.
Whether she wants me to or not?
What does she know?
Think I could have some time off?
You got it. You just go.
Ruby, you know, you're the best.
Come in.
Hi.
Hi.
Are you watching?
Well, I missed one of your numbers. They love you, sweetheart. How'd it feel out there, then?
It's great. Yeah? Always feels great.
Good.
I quit Kelly's.
That's what I've been waiting to hear.
I know.
Why now?
I don't know. Well, I just realized that it was stupid for me to stay around all those people when I could be here.
You okay? Must have been tough.
Oh. No, you know, it really wasn't. I tell you the truth, I don't know why I didn't do it before. I mean, you kept telling me.
Well, I knew you would do it when the time was right. Welcome home. You don't ever have to worry now, Carrie. I'll take care of you. You okay?
I'm fine.
I didn't mean it.
No, it's okay.
Thirsty?
Yeah, that'd be great.
Okay, go ahead, have a seat. I'll fix you something.
About dinner, huh?
Oh, I haven't even thought about dinner. Maybe there's something in the fridge? No, of course not. There's nothing in the fridge, is there?
No, actually, we're pretty well stocked. Yeah, the housekeeper did some shopping when I knew you were coming home.
Well, we could whip something up then.
Mm-hmm.
Or we could have takeout, you know. Takeout would be... I just don't feel like going out, you know, and facing the world right now, if that's okay.
That's okay. You get no argument from me on that one.
So are you and Matt going to, are you going to get together tomorrow and figure out what the next step is?
Yeah, probably. Yeah, honey, I think we need a break from this for a little while, huh? So why don't we, sit down, talk, huh? Come on. Huh? Come on, sit with me.
Sean can't go to jail for a murder he didn't commit.
Then we're going to have to find out who really did it.
I know. How?
Ruby, where's Karen Jagger at?
Karen quit.
What?
Don't start up with me. I'm not in the mood.
I didn't say anything.
Honey, I'm just not buying your act. Got it?
Karen quit.
Why'd Karen quit?
Probably because of something you said.
Me? I didn't...
Or did.
I didn't do anything.
Oh, honey, don't fool me. You've been after Karen since the first day you laid eyes on her, since you first laid eyes on Jagger. Now, here, make yourself useful.
Ruby, look, I really don't have time. I'd love to help, but I really...
Yes, you do. You're going to go take an order from table number three, and you're going to get it right. If you live here, pitch in. Okay?
Pitch in. All right. Which table is table three? This
one,
table?
Two, three.
One, two, three.
Yeah.
Hi.
Hi there. I hope you're not in a hurry.
No.
Hi, Ruby.
Well, who else could it be? Nothing was stolen, right?
Not from the hotel. Jessica's purse was still there.
Money, credit cards, and all?
Yeah.
And there was no sexual assault. Do you think it could have been somebody that she could have had convicted?
It's possible. She's bound to have some enemies.
Did she have any friends?
Good point.
We can get records of all her cases, can't we?
I just had a thought.
What?
Remember Jessica complained to Sean that Chamberlain was threatening her?
Mac.
Anything's possible with Chamberlain.
You know, maybe I shouldn't rent a whole apartment full of furniture. Maybe I should just get like a dresser or maybe a couch too.
Go with your end table that you already got.
Yeah, of course.
Huh?
Of course.
What
end table?
Nah, you weep. Yeah, had to be there.
Oh. You know, there are some places that rent nice furniture, you know. I mean, I couldn't afford to furnish an entire apartment.
Can you wait for about a week?
Why?
Because in about a week, I can get some of Dominique's furniture in there.
What
Dominique's furniture out of my apartment? You're taking my apartment furniture?
Oh, no, Scott, I don't think so.
No, not your... What do you think? I'm just going to get a couple of galoots, go over there and steal all your furniture and leave you sitting on the floor with my child?
You said Dominique's furniture. I had Dominique's furniture in my apartment. That's what I thought you meant.
No, I'm talking about her furniture that's in storage in New York.
No, Scott, I couldn't let you...
Let me ask you this. Do you like Dominique's taste in the way she furnished her houses?
Of course, I think she had great taste. I mean, she married you, didn't she?
Well.
Why?
Thank you for that. That's a very nice thing to say. Because if you didn't like the way she furnished her things, if you didn't like her taste, then I wouldn't, you know, put the furniture on you like this. But you do, so you see, you have a choice.
Is this a trick question or something?
It is a trick question. It was a trick question, but you don't have a choice because the furniture's going to work for you, all right? Let's just leave it at that.
Anybody for dessert?
I don't know.
Too late. I already ordered it, and don't worry. It's not too sweet at all.
Let me get you a refill.
No. I better not. I still have to dance again tonight.
I got one of the other girls to cover for you.
You did?
Yeah, I figured you were having such a tough time. You might want a night off. Is that okay?
That's great. Thank you. Hey, honey.
Yeah?
Thanks for letting me just hang out here.
Well, you're not hanging out here, Carrie. You're here.
Oh, thank you.
You said that already.
I know. I always say that to you, don't I?
So stop. Come here.
want you to do anything you don't want to do.
I'm not.
You sure you're ready to cut your ties off with your friends at Kelly's?
My friends? That's pretty sad, isn't it? I don't know how I could be friends with people who don't even know me.
I'm sorry, Carrie.
It's not your fault.
I know, but, you know, I just want you to be happy.
I am. At least when I'm here with you.
Good. This is a big decision. You know that, don't you? Once you make up your mind that you want to be here, you can't all of a sudden decide to go back. Because there won't be anything to go back to.
Sorry, there's not anything else to go back to now. So what difference does it make? That's my past, and I'd like to forget about that.
I can do that for you.
Where's Stone?
He's running an errand for me. We're okay.
That used to ride around that big wheel when we first started going to the restaurant?
Mm-hmm.
I can't remember his name, but, I think the next one older is Jeffrey, isn't it? You know, the one... You remember when he first started waiting on tables? It was like... It was so depressing.
Yeah, I remember that. Oh, the little one's name is... Evan.
Evan. Evan, that's right. Mm-hmm. That's right.
want some cashew chicken?
Yes, please. Huh? Cashew chicken.
Here we go.
The little one. Uh-huh. I called him that, didn't I? Well, you should see him now. He's not quite so little. I mean, he's actually quite handsome. He's grown up, you know.
Oh.
I think I embarrassed him, though, you know. I think there comes a time in every kid's life when they don't want to be known as, like, you know, saying, I knew you when you were this high and everything like that, you know.
I get it. Hi.
Hey, can we talk to you guys for a minute?
Yeah, sure, sure. Come on in.
Thanks.
Hi.
What's wrong?
Nothing really.
Chinese food?
Got no, plenty. Thanks. We just came from Kelly's.
Been sitting there forever trying to figure out who killed Jessica.
Yeah, we'll join the club.
Yeah, we had a thought.
What?
Sean, a while ago, didn't you say that Jessica was complaining about Chamberlain? That he was making threats towards her?
Yeah, I even had to put a guard outside her apartment. Why?
But he made specific threats, didn't he?
No, actually, they were rather veiled. I mean, that was what frightened her so much. I mean, she could never really pin... Wait a minute.
Ryan?
Look, I know. It sounds crazy.
Sounds worse than that, Mac.
But you can't deny that Chamberlain fits the bill, Sean. But how the hell could he possibly have gotten to Jessica?
Well, can I get you some dessert?
No, I've already taken care of that, thank you.
Okay, thanks. Mm-hmm. How about some coffee, then?
Yeah, I'll have some coffee. Go on.
Hot tea for me, please.
And decaf for me, please.
All right. Excuse me. Mm-hmm. Be right back.
And excuse me, too. I'll be right back.
Oh, okay. Pat of the nose?
You know, I'm beginning to think that Lucy, I wouldn't go as far as to say likes me now, but I think that she tolerates me.
Well, she's starting to come around.
I wouldn't exactly call this coming around.
Well, it's a start. Right?
Okay, I'll give you that. It is a start. And I think I understand Lucy.
I don't understand Lucy. How could you understand Lucy?
All right, well, I've got her figured out a little bit at least.
Really? Clue me in.
Well, remember my theory about how she was close to Dominique and she's close to you and just having your baby, and then here comes Catherine.
Yeah, well, it doesn't hold a lot of water here. I mean, I remember what you're talking about.
No, sure it does. Look, she feels threatened, even by the smallest little things.
Like what? Give me an example.
Well, like tonight, for instance. You made that crack about the box being an end table, and we laughed, remember?
So we're not supposed to be laughing?
No, it's not that. It's just that we laughed, and she didn't have a clue about what was funny.
Well, that's because she wasn't there. We were there.
Exactly. And the closer that I've been watching the situation, I see that it happens to her all the time. When you and I are together, we talk, we have our little in-jokes, and she's not a part of it. And I know it really bugs her.
What's the moral of the story?
The moral is, I think that we should be a little more considerate of Lucy's feelings, and maybe we shouldn't exclude her so much anymore.
Well, maybe sometimes I want to exclude her from a few things.
Well, maybe sometimes I do, too.
No. The truth comes out here.
This is not what I mean. It's just that sometimes I would like to be alone with you a little bit.
Stop worrying about Lucy. She's a big girl and she's getting bigger every day. She's one of my best friends. But you are also one of my best friends. So she's just going to have to get used to it. Because it's not going to change.
Hey, who's back?
Hi. Yeah, well, I'm kind of hard to miss. You are not going to believe who I just ran into.
Who?
I just told you, you're not going to believe it. Hi.
Hi.
Hello.
Scott, Catherine, I'd like you to meet Catherine Crawford.
This is Bill Ritter.
And Dana King.
Sunday, tips on how college students can avoid credit card debt.
Plus the new Miss South Africa and Bianca Jagger on Good Morning America Sunday.
Sunday, if you haven't seen Lois and Clark, you don't know what you've been missing. Lois and Clark, the new adventures of Superman.